Welcome to Jan's Sewing Solutions. Today's tutorial is on regretful and overbearing sewing tasks. This has been one of those challenging tasks that I had taken on, which I I deeply regret taking something like this on, because it has been a nightmare to sew and very economically very unviable. Okay, that's what I would probably add to it. If you are charging something like 15 or 20 pounds for a suit, then let me assure you, taking something on like this is definitely, most definitely not viable, because of the time and effort spent on making something like this. Even though I consider myself to be a very good machinist, items like this present challenge after challenge. And you know, because there is heavy embroidery on these, and the type of embroidery that's done on this is a swastika diamante type of stones that are glued on or stitched on very immaculately, and to take them off you often presents a problem that you are going to create a hole in the fabric, because the base fabric that's used on garments like this is pure chiffon, and you need to be very delicate and very soft-handed to sew something like this. And then often what you're being paid is just not sufficient to actually cover the cost of the extra time that's spent on making this. Now, having taken this on, you know, it's, I mean, this pre-stitched garment was done with a purpose in mind, where it was done for a person. You know, you could sew this in a multitude of sizes. If I was buying this for myself, and if I was stitching it for myself, then I think for someone who's a designer themselves or a machinist themselves, it's worthwhile buying. But for someone who's then going on to give this to someone to stitch to their size, and where the expectations, because the price of suits like these is considerably high, the expectations are quite high as well. You expect a certain type of result from this, and you, when you buy something like this, you have a visual image in your head of how the finished result of a garment like this will look like, and that's not always the case. Sometimes it's disappointing when you have a particular image in your head and then the result doesn't come out like that, and that can often happen due to a result of someone else stitching the garment for you who has a lack of sewing skills or doesn't really truly understand your taste and your perception of what you require. So it's a quite a big challenge, and you know, this was a mistake that I made when I took this garment, that you know, I didn't realize. I mean, I've stitched two of these. I had done one for a nikah outfit for one of the girls, and that also, you know, she was a very slim, probably a size 6 girl, and that meant that you were taking a considerable amount of this fabric away. This one is also quite a small size. We initially stitched this. I actually initially cut this out, and I had given it to my machinist to stitch. And what basically happened was I had pre-marked the finishing line. Now, he didn't notice, well, he noticed the finishing on it, but he was reluctant to cut into the fabric. So what he did was he stitched it, and the result was way too wide, and you know, it just drowned her. And then it meant that we had to repick the whole of the garment and re-stitch it back up, which meant losing a few of the flowers on the sides of the dress, even including losing a part of the kali in this. But there is no other way out except for doing that. And sometimes, you know, when you see a beautiful done-up fabric like this, you just don't want to cut into it. But in order to make it fit right, especially for a very slim person, then you have to be bold and you have to cut into it. So this was one of my regretful taking on of this order, but alhamdulillah, it is finished, and I think, I mean, I'm hopeful now that, you know, she'd be happy with this, and it will fit her right. The other problem that sometimes you present with garments like this is obviously Right, okay. I've already got a problem which I've just realized, and that is that the lining on the one side is slightly overhanging. My thoughts were to actually border this. Unfortunately, bordering, I couldn't find a really relevant looking trim to actually trim this off with. And also, when it's somebody else's order, then if they've not supplied you with the trims and stuff themselves, then it presents you a problem that what if that person comes back and isn't happy with the result that you've gone and created. So that's just another problem. My phone is going off the hook and is ringing like mad. So what that needs doing now is I have to level it out, and I have to trim this down a little bit more. It is actually more so on the one side, and I don't know whether to actually just unpick and do this. Or see, once there's a problem, that problem often leads to another problem, and then leads to another problem, and it becomes more and more difficult. Now, the only way to actually truly do this right is to unpick, press, even it out, press it, and then trim off the bottom. So I was tempted to just cut into it, but I will unpick on this and actually iron it out and then go into it. Okay, so you know what, this has been a nightmare, and it's taken me a good couple of a good day to sort out, and that has really it's actually quite off-putting when you consider how much you've got to do, and then one garment is actually taking you that long to fix. Before I finish off, I am going to go on to show you another one of regretful disaster garments.